saying, that is we are measuring that height of the tree without climbing over here. So one triangle I got, that is XYZ, and another triangle, suppose here, it's a long big triangle. This is a big triangle ABC here. Now since I have taken the small stick, so I know this one, this is XY, length of XY is known to me, XY is known to me, clear. Now as I am on the ground, I can easily measure this length, length of two shadow, means AC and XJ, I can measure, AC, I have this one now, B, AB. Okay, so BC and XJ are known to me. So this is and this is also known to me. Clear? So what is unknown? I don't know that AC and YZ. Now see, since you are reading in class 9, right now you haven't studied, but you have a theorem in geometry that is called similarities theorem. That is called similarity theorem. Means what is the statement of this true theorem? If two triangles are similar, means what is similarity's theorem say? If two triangles are similar, then the ratio of their sides also will be equal. Means what? If this triangle and these triangles are similar, then obviously, see, ratio of the side means AB by XY should be equal to BC by XJ. Clear? AB by XY should be equal to BC by XJ. Now, what is similarity theorem? That is beyond scope of our discussion, but still I am saying, according to the similarity theorem, it is saying that if I am having two triangles which are not looks alike. See, this is a big triangle, this is a small triangle. Means, suppose you and your brother, clear, both are twins. So, you are look similar, but are you congruent? No, you are not congruent. So, there is a difference between similarity and congruent. Your math teacher can give the justification more. Now, remember that since this is right angle triangle, this is also right angle triangle, they are perpendicular and they are standing on the same ground, means that BC and XZ standing on the same base, so these two triangles are similar. So this is AB by XY, you just for now remember that since these two triangles are similar, why? No one will ask because this is physics, not mathematics. So you just directly write, since these two triangles are similar, so AB by XY equal to BC by XZ. Now BC we know, XZ we know, and XY obviously we know. Then we can calculate the height of tree, that is AB. Clear? That is the another applications of what? Applications of that is ruler. So by ruler we can measure this by simple this formula. Clear? Now going for that next application. That is all for today. Only another applications remaining. Now next application is measurement of determination of rate of flow of water from a tap. Means you tap is everywhere in your home. So you can sometimes if I open the tap full, so the flow of water is more. If I open the tap less, the flow of water is less. So what is the flow of water? Means per time, per unit time, how much water is coming out from the tap? How could I measure? So we can measure, that is very easy process. We will take what? A medium size measuring cylinder. Measuring cylinder means just what I discussed. A measuring cylinder you are taking. A medium size measuring cylinder you are taking. And you take a clock or a digital stopwatch. Everyone has a mobile, so we can take a digital stopwatch. Clear? So you are having stopwatch as well as that what we are having as well as that tap. So let's go for that. I am showing you also. I am showing you that also. Wait. I have taken a container and now I will start the flow off from the tap. See, it is completely filled up and the time. So there I have taken a digital stopwatch. Their time I am noting, that is 21 second, and by volume cylinder, that cylinder I can't show you right now because the container what I have taken, that is a 300 ml container. So how much water I have taken, I got, that is 300 ml. To fill that 300 ml I am taking how much time, that is 21 second it is taking. Okay, when I switch on the open the call, that that is time taken 21 second to fill it. So what is there, if I divided that 300 ml by second, 21 second, so what I will have, 300 by 21, so 300 so 1.3 ml per second, clear? So the flow of water is 1.3 ml per second. Now since it is the video for school, I can't repeat that experiment for too long time. So what you will do in home, you just repeat this experiment for four times, then take the average. Okay, so that will be more accurate. So by that we can measure that flow rate, flow of water through a tap. Okay, so that's all for this. In my next video, I will go for that further devices. Thank you, class. So what are the remaining topics? Just remaining topics are, remember that we will do that measurement of diameter of a ball. Next, that if common balance means mass measurement, weight measurement, use of modern devices for time measurement, Now when I am discussing all those things, just remember one thing, that is when you are doing that system of measurement and measuring device chapter, now just don't think so much. Whatever note is provided, read from that. Because if you start thinking so much now, that is you will get confused. So basically that most confusing part is that first one, that is suffix, prefix part, and that megameter, gigameter. So many things are there. Don't take this chapter lightly, because this is a very mark scoring chapter, as well as this is just based on mathematics. So you can score well from this chapter. Okay, thank you.